A PDF of additional material accompanies this program. Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Dabbler's Guide to Witchcraft, Seeking an Intentional Magical Path by Firelight. Read by the author.
Introduction. Let's go on a journey. Let's say you have a boyfriend. For the purposes of this exercise, we'll call him Todd. So, you meet Todd. You fall in love with Todd. The two of you move in together, you buy furniture, and maybe even a ferret. Whatever couples these days do to mark the fact that they're, you know, a couple. Then, the inevitable happens. Some friend or social acquaintance or person auditioning to be the evil character on a reality show sends you the text. It's filled with screenshots of Todd on dating apps, Todd offering up his nudes as though they were business cards, and worst of all, Todd saying that the birthday cake you made him, the one he said he loved more than any other cake despite the frosting being a bit off, was trash. It's enough to make someone reenact a Kelly Clarkson music video and tear his apartment to pieces. But then you remember that you also live there, and if you rip up the pillows, you'll just have to buy new pillows. And sure, pillows aren't expensive, but these particular pillows were. They're those really good latex pillows that stay cool, and purchasing pillows is not something you want to do during a breakup. That's when a helpful friend brings over some wine, some chocolate, a deck of interesting-looking cards, and suggests burning Todd's things. It sounds like a good idea. You get a metal bucket, a lighter, that favorite t-shirt of his that you wear to bed, a few photographs from happier times, and a stack of sticky notes. You cry. You scream. You light things on fire. You write all the little ways he made you happy, one per sticky note, and burn those. You write all the little ways he hurt you, one per sticky note, and burn those too. You drink wine. You dance. You realize that as the fires of Todd slowly burn themselves out, you feel better. You look around the apartment one last time, grab your ferret, and leave. This is magic. And this is how it starts. The intrigue, the curiosity, the interest in magic and spells and real-life witches. If you're listening to this, there's a very solid chance that you've wandered into a bookstore after getting a taste of it. Perhaps his name wasn't Todd, and maybe you weren't burning all of his stuff after a bad breakup, but it could have been a friend who gave you a shiny rock to keep at your desk to keep your busybody coworker away. It could be an aunt who gave you a tarot reading during a warm summer night before a new school year started. Magic finds us in all sorts of innocuous places and points in our lives, and afterwards, leaves us wanting to learn more. It can provide a sense of strength in a moment when you feel weak, sway justice in your favor, fiddle about with the weather, or simply give you the confidence to captivate an audience during an important speech. I'm willing to bet that's how you came to hold this book. You caught a spark of magic, and a little voice inside you is wondering what's next. There are a lot of books that can teach you the basics of magic or witchcraft, and even more that will educate you on spiritual traditions, such as Wicca or Asatru or Hoodoo. The writers of those books, by and large, have spent many years studying their subject, honing their skills, and hope to share that knowledge with all who seek it. This book is not that. This book is for people who, at this moment in their lives, might describe themselves as spiritual but not religious. Seekers who do not identify with any particular religious tradition, but are nevertheless looking for what magic awaits them out in the world. Dabblers who feel a pull towards crafting a personal spiritual path, but aren't sure where to start, what the rules are, or whether any rules even apply. People who might be seeking community in addition to magic. In thinking about what I wanted to say and how I wanted to say it, I thought a lot about the tarot. It's said that the major arcana, all the cards you probably think of when you think of the tarot, death, the tower, the lovers, etc., is the story of the first card, the fool. In most decks, the fool is represented as a youth looking off into the sky in wonderment with a sack of goodies tied to a walking stick slung over their shoulder. They're bright-eyed, eager, and perhaps a bit naive. They've set off on a journey and are about to take their first step, except they don't realize they're stepping off a steep cliff. There's usually a dog barking, a warning to the youth, who may or may not listen in time. The lesson of the Fool card is that life is a journey, and you should look at it with a sense of wonder and excitement, but you should be mindful when taking those first steps. You should learn to look for warning signs, listen to those who came before you, perhaps do a bit more research, squeeze in time for self-reflection, and maybe take a quick break from looking at the majesty of your surroundings to check in as to whether you're about to walk off a cliff. The complicated truth is that there's a lot of cool stuff to explore when it comes to magic, witchcraft, and learning about different spiritual practices and beliefs. However, every cool new thing you can learn comes with a long history of people misusing said cool thing in ways that might take advantage of a person who's in a vulnerable space of self-exploration and spiritual seeking. Especially in today's world, a spiritual journey should be deeply considered, and therefore, this book is for those who are seeking a connection with magic and the wonder immanent in nature, with respect for others, an appreciation of science, and without the urge to drop half your paycheck on supplies to get you started. I mentioned that this book will deal with the fact that some people you may meet might seek to take advantage of you. No, I don't mean watching out for bad witches throwing potion bottles at you in a dark alley in some kind of witch war. I mean people like fraudulent psychics, predatory group leaders, authors, and speakers who make tremendous claims of powers and abilities without evidence for the sole purpose of making money or increasing their own fame. Equally, I mean the generations of teachers, writers, speakers, and others who have quietly and unapologetically been taking from the practices and cultures of oppressed minorities, profiting off of them, and making them part of witchy canon so much that it becomes difficult to parse out when it happened, or whether it's even possible to separate the appropriated from the not. I know, all of that probably sounds daunting. It's easy to become jaded or a bit cynical once you find it all out. I'm hoping that by providing you with this information up front, you can save yourself money, time, and heartache down the road. What's important to know first and foremost is that nobody else owns your spiritual exploration. You can absolutely find both magic and community in a way that will enrich your life. In addition, this book is something of a cautionary tale of lived experience. I've been reading and studying witchcraft and the history of modern paganism for over half of my life. Beyond that, I've hosted the pagan-centric podcast Inciting a Riot since 2009. Insert hipster, I was making podcasts before it was cool joke here. I've had a lot of missteps and gotten quite a lot wrong in my attempt to dive headfirst into the vast world of magical scholarship, but each misstep has been an opportunity to sit in discomfort, learn, grow, and do better next time. It's easy to fear being wrong. It's easy to be afraid to make a mistake because all the bits afterwards don't feel good. I felt this book was important, however, because I have always found it necessary to have honest conversations about topics that might place us in an area of discomfort. Or, to put it another way, I value saying the quiet part out loud. There are a lot of introductory books on witchcraft, magical study, and pagan spirituality, but there are aspects about being part of this community that are, by and large, left off the page. Stuff you might not learn until years down the road and think, if everyone knew this, why did no one tell me sooner? The reasons vary from nobody buys a book about witchcraft to hear about the dangers of unethically sourced crystals to some of this doesn't make us look very good. But I disagree with that premise. I think there is a way to say the quiet part out loud. I think embracing an honest, nuanced discussion of the realities of both magic and the community that practices it prepares you to dig deeper, learn better, and fill your life with magic in a lasting and powerful way. That's why this book isn't filled with answers. Rather, it seeks to teach you that the biggest lesson a dabbler must learn is that being a spiritual seeker is less about coming up with correct answers and far more about asking better questions. So here we are, ready to go on a journey together into the vast world of magic. I can't promise that it'll always be easy, but it's my sincerest hope that it prepares you for what awaits you in your future. Along the way, I'll help guide you through some basics, reframe some expectations, and show you how to think critically while undertaking your spiritual journey. You'll learn to recognize warning signs, spot good and bad logic, what to do with all those crystals and herbs you see everywhere, what the movie Legally Blonde has to do with witchcraft, and perhaps most important, how to craft a spiritual life that is meaningful, personal, and filled with magic. Part 1. Wait, so witches are real? Where magic is concerned, there is always an initial decision, an initial willingness to let it enter your life. If that is not there, neither is magic. Neil Gaiman, The Books of Magic, The Road to Nowhere. Yes. Yes, they are. What, you thought I was going to say no and fill the rest of this book with coloring pages? Witches
are real. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.